Hey guys and welcome to part 8 of building the monastery of Spinjitzu. As always, it's been a long time since the last part, but now I want to show you what I've done. So you can see the front is now completed, the door and the roof on the walls looks pretty nice here from a different angle. Here you can see this plate slides out. It's like a modular part of the mock. And it's to support the platform. I built these red columns and with these pins you can put it back underneath the whole platform. So what I've done the last time mainly is I went on with the mountain. Here you can see I added these plates. Here are some plates missing. And I expanded the left side a lot and now it looks pretty nice in my opinion. This was a lot of work and I tried a lot of different things. And this is the final look so far. You can see on the back side we have the inverted slopes. I have to push the pieces down right. And this part is also modular. It slides out as well. You can see these red columns as well to support the platform. Some pins there. You can see this part is really solid and stable and you can lift it with one hand very easily. And the whole part slides in again. You have to push on the sides a bit so it fits in very well. And now I want to show you how the mock looks with the building that I have so far in a few seconds. So here we are with the building on top of it. I showed you the building in the last video and not much has changed since the last time. I added these walls on the back side, but nothing too special, but I think it looks pretty nice now with the mountain underneath the building. Here you can see the corner overhangs the mountain like in the real monastery, and you can remove this little piece here and you can put in the axle. This is where the motor is going to be, and now you can see the function still works from outside the mountain. So this makes it a lot easier to remove the motor. You can pull it out again and put the piece back on here. The same function takes place here. You can remove this stone part. And there's a little hole, you can hardly see it. And again, here you can put in the axle as well. And the function of the spinning columns works as well from outside the mountain. It's a good hidden feature in my opinion. That were all new things in this part. Again, I'm really sorry for rarely uploading new parts, but it takes a lot of time to upgrade the build, and I guess I have to finish the mountain first to make the stable enough, and then I can start with the rest of the building. So this is gonna take a lot of time, because the whole right side is missing. And yeah, but I guess when the mountain is finished, the rest will go on faster. So thank you guys a lot for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video and like this build. Don't forget to like and subscribe and check out my Flickr as well. See you in the next video. Bye.